Good afternoon, guys. This is Tuesday, actually Wednesday. And I'm going to be adding this lesson today, which is going to be for today and tomorrow, Thursday. So I expect the homework to be handed in on Friday, okay? So again, you have 2 days for the lesson and you have 2 days for handed in the homework, okay? So again, this homework is supposed to be done for Friday. So I just want to clarify something, guys. Listen, if you cannot print this page, remember, you have to draw the plane, okay? Because once you get the table, you have to graph. And if you don't send me the graph, the work is going to be incomplete, so I'm not going to give you credit, okay? So remember, follow the instructions, read everything that I upload to the class, please. It all depends, you know, on you if you want to get a good grade in the fourth quarter, okay? Remember, you got to start this with the right foot. So now we're going to do parabolas again. We're going to graph parabolas when the value of A is less than 1. That means that the value of A is going to be negative, all right? So when the value of A is negative, that means that the parabola is going to be a set face, okay? And if it is a set face, that means that it's going to be a maximum. All right? The homework for today that I'm expecting you guys to do today is supposed to be happy faces, which that means a minimum, all right? Because it goes the other way. Now we're going to do maximum. Now, remember, guys, I'm seeing few kids handling the homework yet, and they're making a mistake. Remember, the axis of symmetry is always the value of x, not the value of y. And some of you are writing, you know, y equals as the axis of symmetry, and that is wrong. Remember, the axis of symmetry is always an equation when x equals a number. So let's refresh this. Remember here, guys, this is A, that's B, and that's C. Remember, so even though if you know how to write this in the calculator, right, I always recommend that would be better for you if you can find the axis of symmetry first. Because if you find the axis of symmetry, you're gonna put that right in the center, and you're gonna pick three small numbers and three larger numbers, all right? And when you go to the table on the calculator, you can just concentrate and the window from here to here, all right, from the minimum to the maximum on the table, right? And you're gonna just find the value of y or each value of x. So, but first of all, let's find the axis of symmetry, okay? So I know here A is negative 1 and B is negative 4. So I'm gonna substitute here. Other students also are forgetting about the negative from the formula. So the first thing I'm going to do, I'm gonna write x equals my negative from the formula. In this case, because B is negative 4, I'm going to put that in parentheses, okay? Divided by 2, which is part of the formula, times negative 1, which is the value of A. And I'm going to solve. So negative to negative is going to give me a positive 4, and 2 times negative 1 is negative 2. So the axis of symmetry is negative 2. So I already have the answer for part A, because in part A, asking me what is the axis of symmetry. So the axis of symmetry, remember, x equals a number, not y equals. So in this case, the axis of symmetry is x equals negative 2. That means that the parabola is going to be, hopefully the parabola is going to go through negative 2 when I graph. Now, what is the importance to find the axis of symmetry? Because if I put the axis of symmetry here, which is negative 2, now I'm going to find three numbers smaller than negative 2 and three numbers larger than negative 2. So smaller is first. Negative 2, so it will be negative 3, negative 4, and negative 5. And larger, then it's going to be negative 1, 0, and 1. And what is the beauty of this? The beauty of this is that I can now just go to my calculator, right? I'm going to do one more time, okay? Then after that, I'm just going to just write the numbers because I already have them. So we don't have to waste any time. So now I'm going to go to y equals, remember this button right here, all right? And I'm going to enter my equation. Remember, guys, if you're going to clean the memory of the calculator, you go Second, right? Let me do that. If you want to clear the memory, right? Second plus, I'm sorry. Second plus, right? 712. Second plus 712. And that will clear out your memory. And your calculator will be set up again, you know, like with the fresh memory. So now that I have y equals, I'm going to put my equation, which is negative. This is what I'm talking about. When you're going to put a negative number, you use this, all right? Not that. Negative is this one. So negative, all right? I did that already. And I go with my x, which is right here next to the green button, all right? Minus, now here is the minus sign, no? Not the negative, minus, okay? Not this one, this one. Minus 2x, right? Minus 3. Remember, it's a big difference. It's a big difference between a negative and a minus. If you notice, the negative sign is small and it comes like a little higher. The minus sign, the subtraction sign, is longer and it's right on the center, okay? So now remember, to get the table, I go to second graph, all right? And I got my table right there. But you remember, every time you set up your calculator, it's always gonna start from zero on the x-axis, you know, because everything is clear. So this is the first, I guess, the first numbers or the first table that the calculator is recording because I cleared out the memory before. So remember, I'm going to concentrate in this window. So I need to get my minimum number supposed to be negative 5, all right? And I should be to positive 1. So what I'm gonna do in this situation is, because I'm on 0, I'm just gonna go up until I get to negative 1. So you gotta go to this arrow right here until you get to negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, negative 5. And your window is right there. Hold on. Negative 2, negative 3, negative 5. What am I doing wrong? Hold on. Because it doesn't look like it's... I made a mistake. Probably it's negative x. Oh, I put minus 2. It's supposed to be minus 4x. My bad, guys. Okay, minus 4. I'm sorry. And I go to second graph, and that should be it. All right, I'll see you now. I'm still negative 4x minus 3. What did I do? Hold on. Negative x. Oh, I'm missing the square. Oh, God. Okay, my bad. Negative x squared. I'm going to write it again. Minus 4x minus 3. Second graph. My bad. So let me go back to negative 5. And this is what I need. Okay, guys? I'm so sorry, okay? So when I enter the equation, I enter the wrong equation. But then again, see, this is my real numbers. So when x is negative 5, y is negative 8. When x is negative 4, negative 3, remember. And guys, you're going to, you know, your hint is when you start seeing this number that repeat, okay? Negative 8, negative 8, negative 2, negative 3, 0, 0, 1. That means that this is the vertex right here. You know that the axis symmetry is negative 2, which I already found it before using my formula. So I'm gonna fill in my table now, okay? And I'm going to graph. So that's supposed to be negative a here, negative a here, negative 3 here, negative 3 here. Then I do 0, 0, and 1. So now I can answer question number letter B, because they're asking me for the vertex or the turning point, and the vertex or turning point now is negative 2, comma 1, okay? The vertex is negative 2, comma 1 from here. So we know we're doing, when we do negative, the leading coefficient is negative, it's gonna be a set phase, so we know it's gonna be a maximum, all right? So in this case, that's gonna be maximum. So let's go back to the graph and we answer the next three questions. So now that I'm going to graph, I'm gonna go, you know, for each other pair. So this is my x, that's my y. I gotta do my scale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Remember, because the numbers are small, I can go by ones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, negative 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, positive 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, negative 5, okay? So I'm gonna start graphing. That means I'm gonna go 5 to the left, which is right here, all right? And 8 down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Remember, you don't count the x-axis, you don't count the point of departure. negative 4. So negative 4 is supposed to be here, and I'm gonna go down 3. 1, 2, 3, so that's my other point. Then I go negative 3, 1, 2, 3, and I stay there because I don't move up, not even down. And negative 2, which is my axis of symmetry, and I go up 1. If you notice, this is my vertex. So after that, I don't even have to, you know, look at the points. I can just gonna do my mirror. So I'm gonna move to the right, and I'm just gonna match up the other point, okay, in the same line. I'm gonna open up, and I'm gonna match the other one right there, and I'm gonna keep opening up. Remember, the parabola is always opening up or closes, it depends. So now I have mine, okay, I have mine parabola. And if you notice, I'm not making lines, and remember your arrows at the end, right? So that's my parabola right there. Okay, so remember, on the homework, you have to draw the plane. Use the ruler, okay, and draw it. And, you know, I like to do my axis of symmetry, even though they don't ask me to do it. So you know that the axis of symmetry is what cut the parabola in half. So there it is. Now that I have my parabola, I'm gonna answer my questions from D, E, and F, right? Okay, so